Hey guys, welcome back to another ZPulse unboxing, and today we're going to take a look at the ZSTX. So this is a hybrid system from KZ, and I did review the ZST like 1 year to 1.5 years ago. It was one of the key IAMs of KZ. That's why they're popular. And this is now the X version, and we're gonna take a look at it and give you guys my unboxing experience in this one. So full review will be in the ZPulse channel. ZSTX upgraded dual magnetic dynamic balance armature. So you're still getting that hybrid configuration. Silver plated cable. So nice that you have a silver plated cable in this one. Definitely an upgrade from your previous usual, brown cable. High frequency detail performance. Weight 22.3 grams, 3.5 millimeter jack, 0.75 millimeter 2-pin connector, 20 to 40 kHz. So I believe this is higher compared to your previous ZST, which only goes to around 20 kHz, 12 ohm impedance. So really easy to drive this one. Sensitivity 107 dB, and you're getting that pretty similar look compared to your usual ZST. The ZST actually is pink and blue if I remember correctly, but the cable is a bit different in this one. So this is your unboxing experience, guys. So really interesting how they tune this one, because ZST or the ZSTS is already a bit outdated in terms of the sound. There's already the ZSN Pro, but will this be a competitor to the ZSN Pro, or will it be kind of like a ZST, a different kind of tuning? That's what we're gonna try to figure out. I'm gonna give you as far as my initial impressions in this one. So let's take a look at what you get inside the box. Opening it up. So this is around under $20, so really good price for something like this. That's what you get. Actually, the logo, the ZSTX, is bigger compared to your previous one. Newly upgraded hybrid technology. Headphones, earphones, opening it up. And of course, in the box, you get tips. Are you getting that usual tips, that usual KZ tips? Because nowadays, actually KZ is updating their line. Sometimes it changes now. Sometimes it's not the Starline tips, sometimes it is the Starline tips. So you're getting the Starline tips in this one. So actually not, I don't have a big issue with the Starline tips. It's already tried and tested. Isolates really well also. Cable wise, actually you're getting white cable, finally. So I do like this one. I do like that they are aiming for a different color, because I don't like the brown cable of KZ, so this is nice to see. They are including a more premium looking cable. L plug at the top, and you're getting of course that 2-pin connector. Actually, the 2-pin connector seems to be the new 2-pin connector, which is nice, the more stable 2-pin connector. So looking at the IAM itself, so I got the green color, which is nice. Of course, links down below for this one. If you want to get it, it will be from our partners here in ZPulse Labs. CST, and not a lot in the box. And let's put in the cables now. So firstly, in terms of the cable, in terms of the build quality, they're similar compared to your brown cable, but I would say this is a notch up, because it's a bit more smooth in the overall texture. It's a bit more shiny, and I do like the look overall over your previous brown cable. So nicely done there by KZ. And the other one, so actually I can't confirm yet if this is the new connector. This seems like to be still the old connector of KZ. So that is the look that you are gonna get. So in terms of the lobes, it's very similar compared to your ZST, the old version, all plastic in design. You don't have that metal kind of build. It's see-through also, and you're seeing that dynamic driver also inside. It does go inside your ear. And you have, of course, that custom IAM kind of shape, contoured kind of shape. It's still very similar compared to your ZST. I wish they upgraded design though, so you don't have your fins in this one. But yeah, this is a tried and tested design. Preformed air hooks also, so that's nice. So let's have a first wear and give you guys my impressions in how this wears on the ear. All right, so on the ear, it's very similar to your ZST. It's very comfortable to wear. It's very light on the ear, so I can see me wearing this for a long listening session. It does isolate okay. So with that Starline tips, I didn't have it. This isolates fairly okay. Not the best isolation that I've heard, but it does isolate compared to other IEMs that I have tried. And in terms of stability, very, very stable in this. I do like the preform Aerox in this one. So nice than this one in terms of the design. So this is false right smack with the other KZs. They do know how to make a good fit on the ear. So let's try to listen to some tunes and give you guys my impressions in how this sounds like. Let's try some Queen, Another One Bites the Dust. Right off the bat, the bass is definitely prominent in the mix in this one. The bass is in the boomy side. The vocals are pretty well placed in the mix in this one. But definitely you still have that kind of shimmer on top because of that BA on top. This is more in the smooth side in presentation. So bass may gravitate towards this one. Let's try some Journey. I like the richness in the vocals in this one. It's not the most revealing though. Let's try another track. Maybe some Bon Jovi, Bed of Roses. Kind of reminds me of the ES4 in a way. Yeah, the vocals are pretty cool in this one. Alright, so that's my initial impressions. Alright, ZSDX. This is a very interesting IEM. This kind of reminds me of the ES4 in a way. It has, that prominent bass at the bottom. So bass heads me like this one. I'm really excited to measure this one to check out how they, tune them. I think this will be a really popular pick for a lot of people. But of course, I'm gonna confirm that in the full review. I'm gonna compare this to other IEMs. Of course, the old ZST, ZSN Pro. I think the ZSN Pro is a bit more bright compared to this one. But I'm gonna do a side-by-side of this one to be sure. But that's our look in the ZSTX. If you have additional questions before the full review, let me know down in the comments below. And hopefully you enjoyed this review. And of course, I do like to, announce that I will have a single release in YouTube. It will be a music video of my first song, so hopefully you guys can support me as well there. I'm gonna link it down in the description and also comments below. And I'm gonna see you guys in the next ZPult unboxing. Bye.